Hello guys, my name is Antonia Anton, studying at SUA, taking Bachelor of Science in Food Science and Technology. Today, I want to talk or to share with you about aflatoxin. Be aware, aflatoxin kills. What is aflatoxin? Aflatoxin is a natural occurring mycotoxin produced by two types of molds, which is Aspergilla flavus and Aspergilla parasiticus. Aflatoxin is a problem particularly in both developed and developing countries because it's a big disaster in our food products. Now, which foods are mostly affected by this aflatoxin? The foods that are mostly affected are cereals, maize, peanuts, and sunflowers, etc. Now, how are people exposed to this aflatoxin? How aflatoxin can be transmitted to the people? Two ways. First, people can be exposed to aflatoxin by eating contaminated foods such as peanuts, meat or dairy products, and also farmers and other agricultural workers may be exposed by inhaling dust generated during the handling of processing these contaminated crops and feeds. So these are the two ways whereby aflatoxin can be exposed to the people. Now, after we have seen how this aflatoxin can be transmitted to people, now I want to talk to you a little bit about effects of aflatoxin. So actually, aflatoxin has a great effect on health, which are, first, it results into malnutrition and stunted growth in children. So it affects also children, and also it has an adverse effect on reproductive health. Nevertheless, mostly aflatoxin affects the liver. It causes liver cancer and liver injuries such as pale liver and the extensive necrosis into the liver. So we have to be very careful while handling food products so that we can avoid this aflatoxin. And also, not only to the health, but economical, it has also some effect. We lose manpower. Aflatoxin kills. So due to this death, we lose manpower. And also, we lose crops in such a way that the crops that are attacked by agent of aflatoxin cannot be used again. They have already been contaminated, therefore they're not good for our health. So we use food and it can cause hunger. Now, let me talk a little bit again about prevention. We need to prevent aflatoxin. Of course, it's a very big disaster. How can we prevent this? In order to prevent aflatoxin, the following should be followed. First, you need to avoid stress to plant. Stress is caused by drought, and where immunity of the plant become lowered. Hence, the plants can be attacked easily by this agent of aflatoxin. Therefore, such agents can either maybe fungi, etc. So therefore, ensure enough supply of water to your crops so that you can avoid this aflatoxin. The second way is to avoid mechanical damage to crops. Some molds damage is aflatoxin accumulation developed during harvesting. So avoid crop damage. Example, we will need to take care of the pod, shell or root damage and ensure adequate ventilation all the time of the when growing the crops. The third one is harvest in time. Harvest in time. Harvest at maturity and as soon as the moisture content allows minimum grain damage. Moisture content should be below 15%. Also avoid harvesting during rain season so that you can avoid these agents of aflatoxin. Agents of aflatoxin are highly exposed to the crops or to the plant during the rain season. When the moisture content is too high, this agent of aflatoxin work best. So don't harvest during the rain season. Now, another one is to keep the cereal in dry, safe and well ventilated room. Transport and store cereal in a dry, safe and well-ventilated room for safe and long-term storage. Now let me conclude, my dear. As I told you before, that aflatoxin kills. The absence of mold growth does not guarantee that a particular food is not contaminated with mycotoxin, especially aflatoxin. So this indicates the need for food analysis to defeat and quantify mycotoxins using rapid, cost-effective equipment and test crews and associated sampling plants. That will allow testing of commercial, sold foods and fruits shipment for mycotoxin level without undue disruption of food trade and processing operation. In addition, enhanced surveillance for mycotoxins will lead to long-term improvement in food safety and public health. Aflatoxin kills. Be careful and be the first agent to prevent aflatoxin. Thank you.